I met this 3D LED setup draft material to demonstrate how we could control a 3D LED setup with a material. So actually, in MindMapper, when you patch DMX fixtures on your screen, you patch it in 2D. But if you have a LED setup that is like a few planes of fixtures, you might want to have like a 3D animations running on it. So that's just a draft, it's not a complete example, but it might you might understand what's possible to do in this situation. So this material actually allows you, for instance, to have a sphere displayed. Actually, I have a sphere, but as we are not working in a 3D, we split the 3D in a few 2D planes. So each corresponding to a depth value, so different Z position. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, I have 16 actually. That's sitting here, 16 planes. That's a depth plane, in fact. And if I move my sphere horizontally, vertically, it moves inside inside the plane. But if I move it in Z, then it will change. I mean, the center of the sphere is going to another depth plane. So I can actually move the sphere. So I did something to so you understand better what's happening. I made 16 video planes that actually are in addition blend mode and with some opacity, so we can see a bunch of planes at the same time. So each of those quads is taking one of the planes of the material here, 3D LED setup material. So you can see that if I take this one, it is showing this part of the media which correspond to depth value. Okay. Oops. And now if I move the sphere, we understand better what's going on. And just like what I did with my planes, we can do the same with LED fixtures. We can map the LED fixtures on each plane and have them in the space, in the 3D space, in the physical real world, and have the impression of a sphere moving in the space. So I have the size. Well, that's a very simple code I wrote. It's called 3D LED Setup Draft. Well, there is a bunch of, so it's MindMapper material actually, so it's like a ISF header, interactive shader format. And inside the code, I just have a SDF sphere function that takes the center position of the sphere. The position in 3D of the actual pixel we want to draw and the radius of the sphere. So I take the 2D position inside this UV area which I receive here, text code, and from this I will make a 3D position between minus 1, minus 1, minus 1, and 1, 1, 1. So here the Z value will be minus 1 and here the Z value will be 1 in this square, and the X is going from minus 1 to 1 and the Y from minus 1 to 1. And thanks to that, I can just use my function to I decide on the sphere center is what you set. here, and the radius also, and I have a function called SDSphere, which will compute the distance at this point from the center, and it's zero around the edges, and then I can render it. So actually, if I would like to have such a setup, I can imagine that I have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 planes, 6 LED bars per plane. So I will do that. I will call it LED plane, LED depth plane, and I will duplicate it for each depth plane I have. So if I have, of course, if I have a setup where I have 8 planes, and I will write 8 here, and then I will have to patch differently. Okay. Oops. No. I could do that. Do. Okay, and then I would be able to drive my 3D LED screen. I don't end with it anyway, you understand. So I did a small sphere thing, a cube, same thing, x, y, z, and radius. And I made a noise, which is actually 3D noise, 4D noise, and you can control the fourth dimension with the speed. I could also have put the X, Y, Z speed or position. Well, anyway, if you would like to do something like that, you need someone who handles coding the shader. But that's an example of what can be done. So if we look at the actual thing in 2D, you have this. In 3D, you will have something that looks a bit like this. That's a noise. And the noise, I took it from some website. It's simplex 4D noise, and that's a function that takes a 4D vector and that returns a float. And here, I give the 3D position of the pixel multiplied by the scale. The scale is this one, okay. And the fourth dimension is the noise time, which is actually animated with this speed. We could make it faster. Just change the speed maximum value to -3. Okay, that's it. So that's an idea how we could drive a 3D LED setup. But there are many other possibilities, like using a 3D editing software, doing renderings from different point of view, and then mapping on the different videos you have. There are a lot of ways to do it. But some people asked me for that, so I wanted just to expose this solution. Cheers.